Azim Mia, and then Jhanzeb of ARY. Azim Mia, please go ahead.
Mr. Prime Minister, now you have met President Trump, so he has met Modi also. He has met him on both sides, and looks like he has got a tilt towards India. So that's one option.
Secretary General says that the resolutions on Kashmir were not under Chapter 7. So according to the
procedure of the Secretariat, Chapter 6 resolutions are non-binding. And in all that kind of a situation,
what are the options left, you know, except appealing to the international
community? Because the international community looks like that right now, in the face of Indian-American alliance, the things are getting bad. So what, you know, what procedures you are going to adopt, and what is your approach, and where are you heading? Thank you.
Acha, Azim, did you say I begged President Trump?
No,
you met President
Trump. Oh, thanks. You I don't. I've never begged any from anyone. So I have met, and I apprised President Trump exactly of the situation, and I have told him, like I have told you, the gravity of the situation. This could go serious. Look, intelligent human beings start thinking ahead. I mean, you have to think of the hope for the best, but you should be prepared for the worst. The worst scenario in this is unthinkable. Normal human beings do not think of that. And so therefore, it is my job to tell them, in my opinion, things will deteriorate. We will keep them apprised. At least we have informed the world community what's going on. And as time goes on, and I fear that this is going to end up in a massacre, at least we will be able to tell the world community. And if India blames Pakistan for this, then at least the world would know about it. Previously, it was anything that happened in India. Look. What has been going on in the past? After 9/11, you used that magic word, Islamic terrorism, and all humanitarian rights were waived aside. You could do whatever you like with the people, provided you could term them as Islamic terrorist. And this is exactly what Narendra Modi is doing. This near genocide which he's about to commit, he's blaming it on Islamic terrorism, hoping that he'll get away with it. And that's why it's important for us to communicate with the Western world and civilized world and tell them what is happening. That's why we're telling them, send your own observers and find out what's happening. If India has nothing to worry about, and guess what the excuse of shutting down, putting people under curfew and shutting them in their houses for 50 days, the excuse is that this is to develop Kashmir. This is for prosperity of Kashmir. This is what the Narendra Modi position is. So it's important for us to tell the world, and I know now, I'm satisfied that at least everyone knows. I've apprised all the major world leaders of the situation in Kashmir.